स्टैंडर्ड 11th सब्जेक्ट अकाउंट्स. स्टूडेंट्स ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 58, क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, चैप्टर 2. सेम एज क्वेश्चन 4, टू विच अकाउंट द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजेक्शन्स विल बी डेबिटेड इन द बुक्स ऑफ गणेश, डिस्क्राइब विद द रीजन. फर्स्ट ट्रांजेक्शन इज 75,000 इज ब्रॉट इन कैश एंड कमेंस्ड बिजनेस. 75,000 इज ब्रॉट इन टू द बिजनेस, दैट इज कैश. सो ऑब्वियसली डबल इफेक्ट में फर्स्ट अकाउंट विल बी कैश अकाउंट. एंड कमेंस द बिजनेस, वेन एवर कैश इज ब्रॉट टू कमेंस द बिजनेस, दिस इज नोन एज कैपिटल. सो सेकेंड इफेक्ट इज कैपिटल अकाउंट. ओके, नाउ कैश अकाउंट, कैश इज एसेट, सो टाइप ऑफ अकाउंट रियल. कैपिटल इज पर्सनल, ओके, बिकॉज ओनर ब्रिंग्स द कैपिटल एंड ओनर इज अ natural person. When cash is brought into the business, what happens in the business? Cash comes in, okay, and capital. Who brought the capital? Owner. So owner is giver. Owner gave the cash, gave the capital to the business. So owner is giver. Now, rule of real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So, comes in means debit. Rule for personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. So, your word is giver. So, we call it credit. Okay. Now, second is incurred puja expense of ₹2,000. Now, students, kisi chote mote रीजन के पीछे, जैसे पूजा पाठ करवाया, किसी को आइसक्रीम खिलाई, ऐसे छोटे मोटे एक्सपेंसेस को हम बिजनेस में कहते हैं सन्ड्री एक्सपेंसेस अकाउंट. ओके, एंड ऑब्वियसली व्हेन यू डू द एक्सपेंस, व्हाट यू डू, यू पे द कैश. सो सेकेंड इफेक्ट इज कैश अकाउंट. यू हैव टू डिटरमाइन द डबल इफेक्ट. नाउ सन्ड्री एक्सपेंस, एक्सपेंसेस आर इंक्लूडेड इन नॉमिनल अकाउंट. And cash is a asset, and asset means real account, right? Now rule for nominal, but first of all let's identify what is this expense. Okay, and when you do any expense you have to pay. So when you pay, what happened? Cash goes out, right? Now apply the rule. As per nominal account, debit all the expenses and losses and credit all the incomes and gains. So here expenses means obviously it will be debit. As per the rule of real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So goes out means credit. Okay, then brought personal furniture ₹10,000. Okay, you bought personal furniture. So obviously one is furniture account, right? Brought personal furniture of ₹10,000. Obviously कहाँ लेके आए, business में लेके आए. So whatever is brought in the business, that is known as capital. Okay, whatever is brought into the business, that is known as capital. And what is brought in the business? Furniture. So this is double effect. Furniture is property. Property means asset. Assets are included in real account. Capital is brought by owner. So owner is a natural person, so its type account is personal account. Now furniture business mein aaya, so what happens? Furniture comes in, right? And capital means owner is giver. Furniture leke kaun aaya, kisne diya business mein? Obviously owner ne hi diya hoga. So owner is the giver. Rule for real account, debit the receiver, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So comes in means debit. In the same way, rule for personal account, debit the receiver and credit the giver. So here giver means credit. Okay. Fourth, deposited ₹30,000 to the State Bank of India. So you have deposited into the State Bank. So one is State Bank of India account, right? And what you deposited into the bank? Obviously cash. Okay, now State Bank of India, this is the institute. Institute means the artificial person. So its type of account is personal account, and cash is a asset. Now, asset means property. Property means real account. Now, when you deposit the cash into the bank, bank is receiver. Clear? आपने पैसे डाले, बैंक ने रिसीव किए. एंड कैश, आपने कैश कहाँ डाला? बैंक में. तो बिजनेस से कैश क्या हुआ? ऑब्वियसली कैश गोज आउट. नाउ पर्सनल, डेबिट द रिसीवर, क्रेडिट द गिवर. सो हियर इट्स रिसीवर डेबिट. Real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So it goes out means credit. Okay. In the same way, fifth, obtained loan of 30,000 from wife. When you take the loan, what comes into the business? Cash. Obviously, one is cash account. Aur kisse loan liya hai? Wife se. So second is wife's loan account. Double effect. Cash is a asset, real account. Loan is a liability, and liability is, remember, always personal account. Okay, now when you take the loan, what comes in the business? Obviously, cash comes in. Or loan kisse liya hai? Wife se liya hai. So obviously, wife kaun bhi? Giver bhi. Now apply the rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So comes in means debit. In the same way, personal accounts rule is debit the receiver and credit the giver. So here it's giver. Obviously, it will be credit. Okay. Next, six, purchase is made of 20,000 and amount is paid by check. You have made the purchase. So obviously, one is purchase account. Good. Then you have paid the amount by check. Check means obviously through bank. So second effect is bank. Check means bank. Purchase is real account because goods are included in real account, and bank is artificial person, so it's personal account. Now when you purchase the goods, what comes in business? Mein kya aate hain? Goods comes in, right students? Aur aapne amount through check pay kiya, to payment kisne ki? Bank ne. So bank is giver. Okay students, now apply the rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. As for personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. So giver means credit. Okay students. Seventh, sales is made of 42,000 and amount is received by check. So obviously one is sales account and you receive the amount through check. So check means bank. So double effect. Sales of goods. Goods are included in real account. Bank is artificial person, so personal account. When you sell the goods, students, from the business, goods goes out. And when you sell, you receive the amount, but through check you have received the amount. So bank is receiver, kyunki aapke bank account mein paise jama ho gaye hain. As per real, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So receiver means debit. Okay students, here withdrawn 22,000 from bank. Kya withdraw kiya aapne? Rupees 22,000. Rupees means cash withdraw kiya. So one is cash account. Kahan se withdraw kiya hai? Bank se. So second effect, bank account. Okay students, now cash is a real account and bank is a personal account. You have withdrawn cash from bank, so cash comes in, right? Aur kahan se paise liye? Bank se nikale. So bank is giver. Now as per the rule of real, debit what comes in, so it will be debit. As per the rule of personal, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Yahan giver hai to credit. ninth transaction is students. ₹2,000 paid insurance premium by check. What you have paid? Insurance premium. So obviously one is insurance premium account and you have paid by check. So bank is included. Bank account is second effect you have to determine. Double effect. Insurance premium is expense and expenses are included in nominal account. Bank is artificial person, so it's personal account. Now students, insurance premium is expense and when you pay the expenses through check, in that case bank is giver. Okay, rule: debit the expenses and credit the incomes. So expenses are debit. Rule of personal account: debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here it is written credit. So credit the giver. 10th, that is on page number 51, 3500 received for brokerage. So one is brokerage account and you have received. Anything received is income. You have received it, so obviously income mili, paise mile. Second effect, cash account. Brokerage received means income. Income means nominal and cash is real. This is income. And when income is received, obviously cash comes in, right students? As per nominal, debit the expenses and credit the incomes. So incomes means credit and as per real, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So comes in means debit.